I feel so grateful that I got to grow up surrounded by a community of hardworking people rooted in the value of family and looking out for each other. And I grew up surrounded by that. It was like a no-brainer to just wake up and do what you love to do and make it work. I mean, I will carry that with me wherever I go. I'd stand in any ticket line, any mountain I would climb, just to find my way to where you are. I started writing songs and imagining what it would be like to get to be a storyteller and play. And I mean, it started locally. This community was an anchor of where I sang for the first time. Pave a path to get back to where you are. And I just had this feeling in my gut that I needed to start pouring everything I had into music and finding a way to make it happen. At the time, I'd been playing for a few schools in our community, and I had just loved watching the look on all of those kids' faces as they felt connected in that moment of sharing music in a gym.
It was time to put together this school tour called Play It Forward, and had to figure out a way to put this mission of getting out to the kids in school, and I had typed out a sponsor package, and Ron was of course one of the first people that I wanted to stop by and visit.
So I started locally, and I went to my local gas station and asked for fuel sponsorship, and I went to my local grocery store and said, we're gonna need food, and it just sort of dominoed like that. I started asking and people started saying yes, and it was like, okay, this is supposed to happen. It was incredible. I mean, we spent 32 weeks in a motorhome, driving all across Canada.
After she did the tour, she said, now I need to go do the writing. I did the performing. I know what it's like to be on the road. I have those under my belt. I need to write.
My dad drove me 45 hours from Grand Prairie, Alberta, all the way to Nashville, and I always dreamed to end up here. I knew it wasn't gonna be a cakewalk, and it wasn't gonna be easy showing up here, but I felt the courage from the people who believed in me and loved me to step up and give it my best and put everything I have into it.
Here for her Grand Ole Opry debut.
Tonight was magical. I'm not sure that I quite have the words to describe what it felt like to look out at everybody in this church of country music. It was such an honor to get to share that with everyone here tonight, and especially with my community. 140 of them that packed into a 737 airplane, landed in Nashville, flooded down this escalator, and just like embraced me with the biggest amount of love I could have ever asked for. It means the world to get to share this with all of them. And truly, these people have been a part of this adventure from the beginning. They have been there, always. They just show up. It's who they are and it's what they do.
I feel like I'm in the place that I need to be, you know, and that house that built me and the community that built me is like a part of the story, and that they're on this adventure with me. I hope that people feel a sense of belonging to this music, and I hope they feel empowered to be who they are. Because I think in all of us showing up and walking out our most authentic story, we give each other courage. Music is just something that takes off the walls and the boundaries around us and kind of just makes us all come together in the same living room.